We start our apostolic travel. We start with the Kitui. Kitui is always blessed. That's where we start. They receive all the cream and all the muscle. We'll be at a place called Miwani, Deliverance Church. That's where the service will be done. Then on Tuesday, we'll be in Machakos. And Wednesday, we'll be in Makueni. Then Thursday, Nairobi North. And Friday, we'll be to Nairobi South in Langata. If you are not able to make it on Thursday, even Langata, you can still come. They will not ask you where you have come from. They will pray for you. Because that's what we normally do. We don't ask people, umetokezea wapi. Tunaombea watu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. If you are visiting us for the very first time, we also want to welcome you in the house. Any visitors, new year, new visitors. This is the second Sunday of the year. If you are visiting us, lift up your hand. Let our usher spot you. There is a visitor over there. There is another visitor over here. There is another visitor over there under that shade. Wherever the visitors are, if you spot them and I don't see them, please give them a hand of welcome. Let them feel welcome. And after the service, there is a place prepared for our visitors. Hallelujah. Last Sunday when we met, in the conclusion, we declared, we did some declarations, but I want just to bring one for you that were not there. As we get ready for the season of elevation, this is what I told the church then. Season of elevation, when God elevates, that no force or gravity can pull you down in Jesus' name. And as the Lord elevates you, no force, no gravity can pull you down in Jesus' mighty name. That's where we concluded, and we'll continue from there. Elevation. Elevation. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Elevation. I want us to read from 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 2 verse 1 to 17. 2 Kings chapter 2 verse 1 to 17. And I will not read actually because it's a story that is known. I'm going just to highlight a few things. But I'll start by reading verse number 1 so that you can know where we are. And it came to pass, when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven, by a whirlwind that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Our Father and our God, even as we sit to hear your word, we pray, dear Father, that you give us an attentive heart, and in this year of elevation, that you are going to elevate us to another level, in the mighty name of Jesus. Our life will never be the same, because we are going to hook ourselves with God the Almighty. For this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. One of the things that I know, if this year is going to make anything for us, we have to understand a little bit about the definition of elevation. Because I know for sure that we want money, we want to be elevated financially. Sawa. We want relocation in terms of our homes and so many other things. But I've normally said that sometimes we miss it because the definition of elevation, we don't understand it. And sometimes I think it's only children, but I've discovered it's not children, even mature people. Faithfulness is the key for elevation. And overflow was also a key. Was faithfulness. Anything that God does for us, the key to it is faithfulness. And if you are faithful to God, then God Almighty brings the blessing that befits us. I almost forgot what I said in the first service, and it is good to repeat the same. That God is good. We are working on the building. You can see it is changing. Now, some of you, when you left, the floor was not the way it is. But they have not finished yet. They have asked us not to wash it so that they will come and do something. They do it on the gaps, and then they polish it. Then they will hand it to us. But right now, they cannot do because we are still working on the floor. But the tiles are here. The tiles are over there. They will finish that part and come with the stairs. It's possible next week they might start putting the frames of the doors. It's possible maybe by the time the daughters of Impact are having meeting, there will be doors to close. So that so that the daughters that will be inside will be closed inside. They can celebrate inside. So we'll have doors. And that will mean at that time, the place will be a bit easier for us to know where the echo is hardest. Because when it is like this, you don't know which area. So we are also working on the ceiling. You can see up there, there are some work going on. And once we start putting the acoustic for the ceiling, then we'll be able to know, the engineers will let us know. They'll come to service with us and know which part needs soft boards and which part needs to be done. One time you'll walk here and you'll wonder, echo irienda wapi, because it has to go. God cannot bless us with a beautiful sanctuary like this and then echo. Some of you were here during the Acacia. Were you here during the Acacia? Of course, the place was so beautiful. Oh, man. But the echo was so bad. But the place was so beautiful. Kwanza kulikuwa na taa zingine zinazunguka huko za marangi. Hey, jamani. Mpaka you wanted to finish quickly so that marangi can be all over and the place can be beautiful. So the echo, the service was so good, the echo. Because for us to beat the echo, you have to feel every place, every, and people standing. If we come, so many of us, feel the place, sit in every seat, and stand in every, close to every one of these beams and columns, then we might hit the echo. But you wait. Atuwezi spendi pesa nyingi hivi. You just wait. Even where even here, this place will change. And I'm looking forward to that. So let's keep on praying. And I know the Lord is going to bless us. Also, although we told you we don't want to have funds drive, we did not want to keep on asking you for money until we use the money that you have given us. So when the money ends, tell your neighbor, Bishop ameanza sasa. When the money ends, we'll come back to you. So get ready. But first, we want to make sure that all your money, you will see it. Ili mtu akikwambia building ni ya pesa ngapi, utamwambia. So that's where I want us to be. And that's why I'm asking them, waputu frames, waweke milango, wamalize hapa ndani, waache maofisi lakini wamalize hapa ndani, ili tuweze kuendelea hapo pengine katika jina la Yesu. Viti bado nakumbuka. Kwanza hicho kiti umekalia, kikalie vizuri ukiambia, one day we kiti ya plastic. One day we kiti ya plastic. Hey, one day. You know, utakuwa ukikalia hiyo ukichelewa. Wale mtakuwa mkichelewa hiyo itakuwa area tu, lakini wale mnakuja mapema mtapata kiti ambayo ni afueni kidogo. Lakini viti vya kule, vile vya studio, hatutaziweka mara moja, tutasubiri kidogo, zina gharama kubwa, lakini tutaweka viti nzuri pia. Hakutakuwa na plastic kule juu. Turudi kwa neno. Wafalme wa pili. Tumesoma mstari wa kwanza. And it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Kwa hivyo ukiona naenda pole pole ni kwa sababu ningependa usikie vile ninavyo sema. He said God elevates, and sometimes he does not use the conventional route. So for you, you have to expect, and unexpected elevation in Jesus. That God might not use the ways that you know. He might use ways that you have no clue. But I have one person who I read his story. He was just an ordinary person. Mtu wa kawaida, akaandikwa pahali. In actual fact, they say he was a janitor. Janitor, kazi yake, diyo hiyo. Hiyo kazi yake. Janitor. Oh, wengine wanaangalia kuniuliza hiyo ni kazi gani. Huyo kazi yake ni kumake sure msalani kuko sawa, kumeoshwa, ametayarisha kila kitu. Lakini alikuwa ni mtu ambaye ana bidii. Na yeye akatafuta executive recruiter, mtu ambaye urecruit executives. Sasa akawa kazi yake ni kurecommend watu wale wanaweza kuwa recruited from his institution. Yeye ni janitor. Kwa hivyo supervisor wake akamrecommend kwa executive recruit, akawa recruited akaenda town ingine. Bwana asifiwe. Janet akafanywa namna gani? Pigwa jeki, akawa elevated. Sasa akawa supervisor. Supervisor wa supervisor. Huyu Janet akampigia yule executive recruiter. Yalikuwa akipenda CV mzuri sana. Sama hapa, my boss is very good. There is no boss like this one. A boss who understands, a boss who does work without any supervision. He does not even supervise me. He believes in people. He has confidence in people. He works very hard kama tinga tinga. And the recruiter recruited his supervisor. So what happened to the janitor? He got promoted. Then the manager of the section, he told the executive recruiter, I have a manager. Oh, this manager is good. He does not lead from behind. He leads from above. He has wonderful examples. He is a mentor. He is so good and so loving. We work even when he does not tell us to work. We come to work not at 8. We come at 7:30. We don't leave at 5. We leave at 6. Not because he's asking us. We love being there. He was recruited. The manager was recruited. So who gets the position? The janitor. Then he talked about his deputy general manager. Oh, what a general manager. He has managers behind him. And he's a good man. He sends us to all seminars and workshops. And we are trained. We are trained. He trains people. He's a trainer. He's a thinker. He's a powerful person. The deputy general manager was recruited. So who takes the position? The janitor. I want to speak to people that are listening to me. One way for God to elevate you is to push the guys that are before you, and you don't push them by praying negative prayers. You push them by talking good about them to executive recruiters. Now, if you have a boss and you want to sit on their seat, look for an executive recruiter and talk good about your boss and recommend him so highly. Sasa unajua shida yetu ni kwamba boss ni mbaya, sura yake, kwanza apendi watu, akiingia lazima sote tusimame, kwanza chai, alikataza tuwe tukinywa chai, sasa huyu ni boss wa aina gani? Hiyo recommendation ukupeana executive recruiter, hata mrecruit, kwa hivyo atabaki tu pale, akikufinyilia. There's another man, was he Kennedy in the U.S. He was an attorney general. He was a brother to the president. The president was also a Kennedy. Now, the attorney general, every time lawyers would be recruited into the department in the U.S., and you know there's a big country, he would tell the lawyers, welcome to this small department. It is small because if you work hard, I will know. If you don't work hard, it is a big institution. Nobody will know. Work hard like I did. One day you might become the attorney general. Those are good words that somebody can speak because our promotion comes when we promote and encourage others. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let me share the story that we read in the book of 2 Kings, or that you are going to read of 2 Kings. It is a story of Elisha. Elisha. The story of Elisha, if you like, if you read all of it from where it starts, you will find that friends and enemies mocked, despised, talked ill about him, discouraged him, trying to push him from his focus. Elisha. But because Elisha put his trust in God, you remember when Elisha was passing by and Elijah was passing by and called Elisha, what Elisha did was to make sure there was no way he can go back. He was plowing. So what did he do? The oxen that he was using, he cut them into pieces. The wood that he was using, he made a bonfire, sacrificed those oxen, and then followed Elijah. Meaning, there was no way he would turn back. No mockery, no challenge, no intimidation could bring him back. I want to declare to you, my brother, my sister, in this year of elevation, if you want God to elevate you, don't allow any mockery, any intimidation to stop you from your focus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. May all your enemies one time come to bow before you. For Elisha, when he received the double portion, when he was coming back, the same prophets that were talking ill about him, they bowed before him. And one of these days, there are people that are going to bow before you, not like God, but in reference and honoring you in the mighty name of Jesus. May the despisers that mock you, may one day, as God promotes you to the next level, come to honor the God, the Bible, that you believe in. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So the sons of the prophet were mocking Elisha, but as soon as he was promoted, elevated to the next level, with a double portion of anointing of Elijah, when it came upon him, the Bible tells us, they came to meet him and bowed to the ground before him. 2 Kings 2 verse 15b. Listen to me, somebody. It is true that no one recognizes you or even remembers you in your family any longer. They have forgotten you. You are the youngest. You are the little. But as you move to the level that God is going to elevate you, these same people this year will recognize you. They will put you in a decision-making level in the mighty name of Jesus. You know why? Because as God moves you, he gives you influence. You know, I like what Bishop Mark says, which is, he says this. He knows what it means to serve the Lord with money and to serve the Lord without money. He knows the difference. And I also know the difference. The difference. When we moved here, nobody wanted to associate ourselves with us. Actually, they said we were a cult. Even to give us a place to start church was a challenge. But today, talk about Deliverance Church, the chief, the DO, the commissioner, the OCPD, everybody. The MP who wants to be an MP, the senators, whatever. They want to associate themselves with the Jimmy Kenny Kimani. What happened? The elevation that God moved us, elevated us to a level that we influence. Actually, anybody who wants to sell a plot in this place, do you know where they start first? They come to Betha. Betha and be a bishop. Kuna plot hapa. That's what they do. Kuna shamba hapa. They think we keep on buying plots. But you know why? Because God has lifted us. You wait until we finish the church and we put Cabro from the gate, that you don't find Matope here. That's the time you will know even some other people that have never shown their face here. Utaona wakipaka Mercedes zao, because they will know, actually, you know what? It is like they will discover, hapa unaweza kuja na Mercedes na isigongwe. Inaweza gongewa huko kwingine. But they will be saying, hiyo kanisa, hata vumbi hakuna. May God elevate us to that level. But I'm also talking about you, that people will start talking about you. You remember when you used to go home and you land in a matatu with the mud and you yourself with the matope, nobody greeted you until you came home one day with a suit and people wanted to greet you. Everybody, how are you? Are you all right? Now go with a vehicle. Everybody called you, calls you Mheshimiwa. Unajua kuna gari zingine tunaperekaga kila mahali. Hata uende Bungoma, Kakamega, wakikusimamisha, wanakuita Mheshimiwa. Kura hizi zote ni zako. Who said you, I want kura? I pray that God will elevate you to that level that people will call you, sir, in the mighty name of Jesus. I met one member that was a member here when I was coming from Nakuru with Alice, and we stopped and we started talking with him. You know, he was in this church, and lo and behold, nobody recognized him. Nobody talked about him. He was not a leader. He was just a member. But I knew him, and we were friends. I went to his wedding. I wedded him. He was here, like some of you are here. But you know what? Lo and behold, the Lord lifted him up. So when we met, because you know the way you meet with the people. So I met him, and he was not even seeing me because God has blessed him. Blessed. Unajua kubarikiwa hata kwa, you know, God allows you to go this way, but this way is you who decides how far you want to go. So God has blessed him this way. So where we were, I'm telling Alice, that is so and so. So I call him. I say, he's him. So I call him. He turns around. He says, "Hi, Bishop." And then he comes. We start fellowship. And as I go to clear, because it was the hotel where we were clearing, as I go to clear, the wife comes. And I speak to the wife in Kikuyu behind her. I say, "Horoaku." She turns around and hugs me like she doesn't want to let me go. You know, I'm just wondering, hey, what has happened? So when she finished, "Sawa sawa. So how are you?" Now I'm trying this so that you can see how God elevates people. After we talked, he took me outside to see the car that he drives. Oh my goodness. Si unajua kuna gari hata ukionyesha mtu unafurahi. Bwana asifiwe. Kuna gari hata wewe mwenyewe unafurahi ukionyesha mtu. Sawa. Gari yako ya kwanza. Ukionyesha mtu, si unafurahi? It doesn't matter ni aina gani. Iwe ni Volkswagen KRW 672. Naita watu waone blue yake, rangi yake, vile iko. Sawa sawa. Well, you know, the first car, hata unaweza piga round bila kuongea na watu tu, unafungua vioo tu, upige round. Na wale wakuoni unawaita, "We, sasa niaje? Ukoje?" So that they say, "Haya, koraga ile gari." You know, that kind of a thing. But that's not him. This is not his first car. This should be his sixth or seventh car because I know him. He was a member here. But this car, ni ile hata ukionyesha mtu. Hata awe nani. Oh, ni ile watu wengine wanasemaga, "Hiyo gari umetaja ni aina gani? Ni mashini ama ni gari?" Hiyo ni mashini. It's a machine. So when we went to see it, I told him, "My brother, you know God has elevated you. He's a director of Kenyatta University planning. It's a company that is planning Kenyatta University in Rwanda. So he is the director of that company." So I told him, "Wewe, askari akikusimamisha na kuulizaga aje?" They normally ask, "Sir, who are you?" Because they don't want to arrest you first. Unajua kuna gari ingine, when they stop you, what do they ask you? "Driving lessons, mzee. Wacha kuniangalia hivyo, leta lessons." But there are others. "Sir, who are you?" Before they ask you your lessons, they first of all want to know, "Who are you?" "Mheshimiwa, pole sana kwa safari," they ask you. Kuna wengine tukisimamishwa, "We, weka kando. Leta driving lessons yako." There is even one I told that I'm a bishop. He says, "Bishop is a title." I said, "Nikamwambia, inspector ni title." Oh, hata yaka cool down. Anyway, the point is, when God elevates you, even your enemy will know you have been elevated. And that's what I'm saying. May God elevate you so that your enemies recognizes you have been elevated. Wacha ile elevation ambayo hata uki, unajua kuna elevation ingine. Then when we were talking with him, I remembered Janet. You know our sister Janet in Kigali? So I told him, "I also know somebody." "I also know somebody in that land working for immigration there for their embassy." Then he told me, "Anaishi nyumba kubwa. Hao ni watu wakubwa." And then I said, "God, you know how to lift your people. Janet, for us, you know, Janet, to Mudhaiga in Kigali, may God do the same to some of you." Blessed be the name of the Lord. Elisha was lifted up. They bowed. It is true that nobody recognizes you, remembers you, and people have forgotten you, but I tell you, they will remember you. They will remember you. They would like to know who you are. You know, for Joseph, he was promoted and lifted to the next level, elevated to the next level. If you read Genesis 41, 40 to 44, and I want us to read for a little while. Joseph, and we have talked about Joseph, and you cannot read about the story of Joseph and not feel excited. But before I read there, I want to say this. Joseph was elevated twice. Tell your neighbor, elevated twice. Because, you know, our God is a God of, he can do it twice. He can do it thrice. He can do it 10 times. He can do it 100 times. God is not tired to bless you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And some of you have been forgotten, so that when God remembers you, you'll be pushed until everybody wonders where you have come from. This story of Joseph, when Pharaoh is talking to Joseph, it says this: "You shall be over my house." Did you hear that? This is Pharaoh saying, "You shall be over who? My house. And all my people shall be ruled according to who? To your word. Only in regard to the throne. Kitu tu si yako ni kiti. Mwambie jirani yako hata sitaki kiti. You know, some of us struggle for kiti. Me, I don't want a kiti. I want to be elevated to a level that I am the one who says. Now, this simply means Pharaoh is saying, I will not say anything. You are the one who will be saying. Me, I will just be sitting. I don't want to be a, you know, Ababu Namwamba. You remember what he said? I don't want to be a general without resources. I want to be a general like Joseph with resources. Not to sit on a seat. Pharaoh, therefore, in other words, Pharaoh, Iyo unafikiria. That was Pharaoh. Kazi yake ni kukatu. Who was ruling? Joseph was the ruler. His word meant everything. Nobody will be greater than who? Than you. Pharaoh is telling Joseph, you're even greater than me. Nobody will be greater than you. Your word is final. Change of guards. Joseph was lifted twice. The first one was he was a slave. In a little while, Potiphar made him the owner of the house. Actually, and Joseph repeated it. He told Potiphar's wife, your husband has given me power over everything apart from you. In other words, Joseph was everything in Potiphar's house. It was only the wife that he could not touch. And God is able to lift you. May God help us to have that focus, that God is able to lift me. It does not matter where I am at the moment. Whether I'm a house help, a house girl, whatever you call it, a house boy, whether I'm just a simple mechanic, God has power to lift me to another level. And he won't ask anybody for help. He has ways to do it. Joseph was lifted. But you know, and I want to say this, why I said twice, is because some of you, God wants to lift you again. Because he lifted you once, but you have gone down again. May God lift you up again. And going down the second time was tough. Because where Joseph went down, he went down, down, ile unasema down, down kabisa. Do you know you can go down kabisa? He went down kabisa until he could not be heard. And I want to say a little thing, a few things about what happened to Joseph. And this I'll be saying as I speak about what prison experience is all about. Prison experience. Because sometimes we get ourselves to a place where we don't know what is happening. We are worried about our tomorrow so much. But you know, prison is a place where you have no freedom. God had given you freedom in Potiphar's place, but he puts you to prison. You go down to a place, you have no freedom. You get to a place where you are in punishment. You go to a place where you're full of intimidation and fear. Prison, where you have no authority, no power, where people have to tell you what to do. They have to tell you when to wake up. They have to order you. But it does not matter where I am. God is going to lift me again. That is his promise. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because God wants me to take me to a place which is a palace. And the difference between prison and palace is because when I go to a palace, I am the one who says what should be done. Prison, I'm told. Palace, I say. No wonder Pharaoh is telling Joseph, your word at your word. Your word at your word. This nation will be ruled and governed. It will be ruled and governed. A palace is a place of honor. Prison dishonor. And I pray that God will lift us from a place of dishonor to a place of honor. Blessed be the name of the Lord. A place where you are ruled to a place where you are ruling. A place where you are under authority to a place where God gives you authority. From a place where you have no color, no decoration, to a place where you are decorated and honored and respect. From a place where you don't relax to a place where you have relaxation in the mighty name of Jesus. That was Joseph. May God bring it to pass. But how is God going to do this? When I understand proper definition of elevation. Proper definition of elevation is for me to get closer to God. God wants to elevate me so that I can know him, whom to know is life eternal. Knowing that there is nothing around me or within me, that it is by my own power. It is all by the grace of God. Knowing that wherever I'm going next, I need God to hold me. Can you put on Isaiah 45? Isaiah 45 and verse 1. Isaiah 45 and verse 1. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have held. I have held his hand to do what? To subdue nations before him and loose the armor of kings. Loose the armor of kings. To open before him the double doors so that the gates will not be shut. In this year of 2016, I want to declare to every one of us, if we are going to be elevated, put your hands in the hand of God. Let God hold you. Let God have a testimony about you. Cyrus was not a believer, but God says, Cyrus, he is in my hand. And if he's in my hand, I have a purpose for him. What is the purpose I have for Cyrus? The purpose I have for Cyrus is, first of all, to anoint him. Is, first of all, to hold him. Why do I hold him? So that he can subdue nations before him. To loose the armor of kings, to open before him the double doors. God has the power to open double doors for you. So that you don't jipenyeza. The door is open so wide for you. And the rulers before you are put down. May God do that to you in 2017. The year of divine elevation. Blessed be the name of the Lord. That nobody should stop you from getting to where the Lord wants you to be. So what am I saying? I'm saying, although they don't remember you, the family no longer even understands who you are, I'm praying that before long, they will come to recognize you. They will consult you. They will talk about you. They will not eat before you pray. They will not eat before you preach. They will open those doors. When you are getting saved, they say, come honoki. But they will honor you because of your lifestyle and what God has done. They will not move until you tell them, it is time to move. May God lift you and push you to that elevation so that in your place of work, they will say there is a Christian. The behaviors that they were doing before, they will start honoring you. Why? Because God is going to elevate you to another level. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, from a position of obscurity to recognition, from becoming nobody to somebody, from lack, you become a person with abundance. From failure, may God turn all your failures to success in the mighty name of Jesus. So Joseph, from prisoner, prime minister, and actually the most powerful prime minister, not sharing, not 50-50. He was given 99 by Pharaoh. Pharaoh was only sitting. You know, if you like a better definition for that, he's like the president of Israel. He sits. But who rules? The prime minister. Or the queen of England. She sits. Who rules? The prime minister. So, Egypt. Pharaoh sat. Who ruled? Joseph. May God turn tables for you. I know some of you are not even getting it now, but as we continue, we'll talk about elevation until you are elevated. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, Joseph was elevated. The other person that was elevated was Esther. Esther was taken to another level. And I said Joseph was lifted the second time, but where he was coming from was the lowest. Esther is lifted from her lowest. Blessed be the name of the Lord. From her lowest. God knows where you are, and he can lift you from there. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know some of us, we are orphans, even when you're over 60. I refuse to be an orphan at 60. So ni orphan gani huyo? Huyo ni orphan wa aina gani at 60? I'm not an... Actually, if we ask the orphans to stand, sitai kuuliza, because there will be more orphans standing here than those that have fathers and mothers. You're only an orphan until you get an ID and start working. When you start working, you're not an orphan. Now start helping orphans. Wanahitaji orphans kwa wanao wadogo. Wanahitaji msaada. Kwa hivyo kama uko 25 na uko kazi, wewe si orphan. Kama una kazi unataka msaada, wewe ni orphan. Now I'm saying this to say this. This weekend I have had a very interesting experience. Somebody calls me, Bishop, I'm a widow and I've been mistreated. Kuna mtu ana pesa zangu anakata. Before she finishes, she starts crying. And I'm not the one who owes her money. A widow. And you know you are a widow and you are working. And you want people to sympathize with you. There is something wrong with you. Because how many people are working, like where you are working, and they are not married, they are single, and they are taking their children to school and to high school, for that matter. But you are still claiming a scripture in the Bible. You are God of the widows, the father of the fatherless. And then you quote another one. We, ukikataa kusaidia widow, wewe, Mungu atakuona. That's kind of a story. Nikikuonyesha simu yangu, ameniandikia tu message tukali sana. Paka to a place we almost said, and today, this morning, I think today when I told Alice what happened, she said, you had a lot of patience. Actually, I had a lot of patience. Because normally somebody like that who is crying before me, lazima atoke na kitu kwa mfuko. Lazima kitu kitoke. But this time, I don't know why. Hakitoki, nauliza Alice, turute. Naniambia, tusimame imara, tujirinde, tuombe. Sure enough, after prayer, she wrote me, the last message she wrote me was to bless me. Bless you, Bishop. Live forever. Nimelipwa mshahara. Hallelujah. I refuse to be a widow when I'm working with my hands. In other words, don't allow yourself to live under sympathy. Kwa sababu watu wakisympathize na wewe, wakikataje, ati oh, I'm just a single mother. Single mother who? Obama is the president of where? From who? Single mother. Single mother who? Ata usiki, drive wa kenyirio kiugogo. Don't you feel funny? Don't you feel funny? May God elevate the single mothers here. May God elevate the widows here. May the orphans here be elevated so that they feel they are something else. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. I feel like I want to preach, but I don't want to go that direction. Remember, thus says the Lord to his anointed, and you are his anointed. And he anoints you regardless of where you are. Sarah is not a believer, but I have anointed him. I'm holding him. There are some things that God wants to do, and he wants to use you to do it. Let's go back to Elisha. Or before we go back to Elisha, Esther. Who was Esther? An orphan. An orphan, and then a queen. How can you be an orphan and you are the queen? It's us who want to us to sympathize with Esther. Esther was who? And Mordecai knew. So Mordecai is put under pressure. And Mordecai goes and puts Esther under pressure. And he says one word. Esther, you don't know why you are in that position at a time like now. But Esther, can I tell you the truth? God can use you. But if you refuse, help will come from another source. Now maybe that is what we need to know that. That you, God has placed you where you are to bring change. But if you don't, change can come from somewhere else. If God has elevated me, I want to be an elevated person. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So Esther took her position, and I want to pray, no matter your situation, no matter the condition you find yourself, year 2017, you shall move to the next level in the mighty name of Jesus. There will be elevation happening to you. David was the least. He was the youngest. And there are some of us here that every time there is problem, unataka kutukumbusha, mimi ni baby. Baby at 60, 50, baby who? Ati, unajua kwetu mimi ndio baby. You are looking for sympathy. I refuse to be a baby who has babies who have babies. I'm getting the point. I refuse to be the baby who has babies and the babies have babies. If God has elevated me, I want to be what? Elevated there in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Yay! David was the least, but God made sure, although he was the least, he was pushed from last to first. I like the Bible. The first shall be last, and the last shall be first. Hesabu ya Mungu na usinikali. Na Matiangi anataka kutumia hiyo hesabu ya Mungu. Anataka kufuta index. Anataka wewe uwe Mkenya. I know some of us have a problem with that. Matiangi anataka uwe Mkenya. Ukienda university, uende Mkenya. Najua hii kipande yetu, yangu imeandikwa Nakuru, Naivasha, Karate. Lakini niichukulia igembe. Maua, it should be a Kenyan. But everybody must, akisoma anasema, oh. Na kwanza kuna mbali tulikuwa tukijaza zamani. Sijui kama nyinyi mlijaza juzi. Hata unajaza dini yako. Na muherega. Shindwe. Sitaki kuhubiri habari ya muherega sasa. Wacha ni wache serikali tufanya kazi yake. David was last, but God brought him back. 1 Samuel 16. When it was time to lift up Mordecai, elevate Mordecai, he was at his lowest. At his lowest. Haman had planned to kill him. He had even prepared gallows. May the gallows that have been built for you, may the enemy of your faith go to those gallows. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says the king could not sleep. May someone not sleep. May someone who is holding your resources not rest until they find you out. The king could not sleep. Why? Because the king had needed to do something to remember Mordecai. So the book of remembrance was brought to him. There is a book of remembrance and it is held by God. May that book of remembrance go to the hands of God so that he can remember you. May God remember you and elevate you. I know you have prayed 2016, the year of overflow, no overflow. May God overtake you now with not only overflow but elevation. May God remember you. There is a book of remembrance. I don't want only to be in the book of life. I want to be in the book of remembrance. Hezekiah goes to the book of remembrance and God remembers him and heals him. There is a book of remembrance. The deeds that we do for the Lord. Mordecai was remembered. But Haman was hanged on the same gallows he had made. Listen to this. He who digs a pit shall fall into it. Every grave the enemy has dug for you and your family, may the enemy himself fall in that grave in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy shall fall in that grave in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, church. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, this is a year of elevation, man. Allow yourself to be elevated. Do you know how to be elevated? Put yourself in the hands of God. Let God hold you because he knows your purpose, what he has for you. Even though the enemy has planned destruction for you, may the enemy himself fall in those destruction. May the arrows that have been set towards you, time to return to sender is now. Return to sender. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know some of you have arrows. You can see those arrows that have been sent to you. You need to stand up and say, you arrows, return to sender. Let them go back to whoever has sent them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, I love this. Hallelujah. Moving on to your elevation, you need three D's. Three D's. D number one, desire. You have to desire that where you are, you need to move on. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Desire. yani una desire kabisa. Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego in the book of Daniel, these three had a burning desire to serve God and God only. Yani wanamwambia mfalme hata ukituchoma tuchome, but sisi tunaabudu Mungu wa milele. For elevation to happen, the desire that you have must be burning within you to glorify God and to honor him. May the fire of God come upon us. May our desire burn us in the mighty name of Jesus. The second D is determination. That this year, I'm determined for elevation. I'm determined to be elevated. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And finally, dedicate yourself for that elevation. And God will do exactly that to you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. May the Lord lift you from where you are. May the Lord put you to where he wants you to be in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I want to finish at that point, that God can lift us from whatever situation we find ourselves, that God can deliver us, can lift us. Psalms 79:11 and Psalms 102:20. God can deliver those appointed for destruction and death. God is able. It's also good to know God has the power to loose the prisoners. Whatever prison you find yourself, Isaiah 14, Psalms 146, verse 7. Isaiah 14, verse 7, the devil never allow his prisons to go free, but God will deliver you from the jaws of the devil. Remember, the power of God through prayer can penetrate the dark wall of prison like it did for Peter when he was in prison in the book of Acts 12. May the Lord God remember us in this time that we are praying and fasting. May this be the place that God will find a ground to lift us up to another level and elevate us to another level. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, dear Father, you will lift us to another level. You will elevate us, Heavenly Father. We'll be men and women on influence where we are. The three D's will work in our lives. Because we desire, there are things that we are going to put aside. Because we are determined, there is a focus that we are going to align ourselves to. And because, Heavenly Father, we are dedicated, our thoughts and our life will be dedicated for this elevation in the year 2017. We thank you, Lord. The best elevation, my brother, my sister, is elevation from sin. If God can lift you from that mild clay, from a pit of sin, from sin and confusion, bring you to where he is, lift you to where he is, that is the best elevation that can happen to you in 2017. And I want to give you an opportunity. Are you in this service? And you say, today, the second Sunday of 2017, that I'm going to live my life for Jesus. I'm going to give him my life, my soul and my body. And you are in this service. If that is what you are saying, if you lift up your hand, I'll see it quickly and I'll pray for you. If you shoot it up, I'll see it and I'll pray for you. Wherever you are, just put it up. I'll pray for you in the name of Jesus. New year, you want to give your life to Jesus. New resolution, you want to say yes to Jesus. This is you saying, in this year, Lord, may you elevate me from where I am to another level. Father, we thank you and we give you praise. Thank you for speaking to us. There is nothing that can stop us. We are unstoppable when it comes to your elevation, because we are held by your hand and you have a purpose and a reason for us. We thank you, Lord, and we give you praise. For this we ask in Jesus' name. Let's appreciate the Lord, shall we?